Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. Today we've got a fun experiment where we're going to see what happens if we put a microphone and a speaker in our vacuum chamber. As many of you probably know, sound waves are vibrations in the air around us. And so in theory, if we take away that air, those sound waves should no longer propagate and we shouldn't be able to hear anything. We want to try putting that to the test in a few different ways. As a first test, let's try putting our speaker into the chamber, but leaving all of the air in and see how much of the sound our microphone can pick up right outside the glass.
Wow. That's a huge difference right there.
Well, I guess we know that glass and thick plexiglass does a good job of dampening sound all on its own. All right, I think we've pretty well established what it's gonna sound like with our speaker in air inside the vacuum chamber, so now we need to try pulling out the air. But I also want to make sure that we aren't just blasting too much sound straight into the glass, because that can also conduct the noise. So to add a little bit of padding, let's throw some cotton balls down into the bottom of our chamber and make sure that our speaker is facing the correct direction. This speaker actually blasts the sound out of the back, so we'll try putting it face down on top of a pile of cotton balls to make sure that we're really playing into a vacuum as much as possible. That seems like a good amount of cotton balls. It should keep our speaker off of the glass so that the sound is just projecting into the air, or the lack of air, once we pull a vacuum. Now let's try pulling out a vacuum, hope that our Bluetooth speaker still works in a vacuum, and see if we can hear it. All right, air is being pulled out. I admit, I hadn't actually tried seeing what happens with cotton balls in a vacuum before just now. I don't think it's gonna do anything, and it looks like I'm right. They aren't puffing up the way marshmallows do, because they aren't holding any air. There's just air in between the fibers. This is looking good. Almost up to a vacuum. We have very little air in there right now. At about 25. On this pump, the most vacuum it pulls is about 26 inches of mercury. All right, that is really close. We're gonna try calling that good. Let's see how well we can hear our speaker or not with a vacuum. Here goes, playing the same clip of music. Oh, if I touch my ear to it, then I can hear a little tiny bit. It's extremely quiet. And I can't hear anything if it's on the glass. It's only on the plexiglass side where the speaker is actually pointed right at it. So there may be a tiny, tiny bit of air still in there, or maybe it's conducting directly through the speaker, into the cotton balls, into the glass, through the rubber, to the plexiglass. I don't know. I'm not sure how it's getting there, but like this, I can barely hear the faintest music. Other than that, see, I'm gonna try like touching this microphone to the plexiglass. I don't know if it'll pick anything up. That is so quiet. All right, let's let the air back in while it's still playing, and we'll see what happens. I'm letting it in slowly so we can kind of see at what point we can hear it. I'm hearing a little bit of it now. All right, that seems like a pretty good conclusive test to me that this does not play well through a vacuum. There was just the tiniest bit of sound that was able to get through somehow. Maybe there's just a little bit of air in there. Maybe it was conducting through the other materials inside the chamber, but it was almost completely silent. So now let's try switching. Put the microphone inside, the speaker outside, and see if the microphone can pick anything up. All right, let's pull all the air out and then we'll turn on the sound and see if the microphone can pick anything up. All right, let's call that good. Our microphone is still recording. We'll see if it can pick up any of the sound. Here goes. Now, also as an experiment, let's try touching the speaker to the glass and the plexiglass and see if it picks anything up like that. All right, let's let the pressure back in and we'll find out how it went. I'll try letting some music play while it depressurizes to see at what point the microphone starts picking things back up. There we go, microphone in the vacuum chamber with the speaker outside the vacuum chamber. Now I want to try putting both of them in the vacuum chamber with the cotton balls and then pulling the air out. And I think I might actually try letting the sound run as the air pulls out so we can see if it just slowly drops off as we run out of air. Let's give it a shot. Get our speaker in here, make sure it's not touching the walls. Microphone in there. All right, there we go. We've got both of them in there. Let's get the sound going and then start pulling out the air and see if we get that sound to just seem like we're turning down the volume knob. I can hear it if I touch my ear to the plexiglass, like really press it on there. I think I can even hear it a little bit with my ear on the glass itself this time. Oh, it's super quiet though. All right, let's let the air back in while it's still playing, see what kind of result we get. Alright, there we go. Both the microphone and the speaker in the vacuum chamber at the same time, pulling the vacuum while it's playing music. So hopefully we can hear the sound diminishing as it loses the ability to transfer the sound through the air. Now I've had a chance to go and listen to the sounds that the microphone recorded while the microphone and the speaker were both inside the vacuum chamber with no air. I really thought that the sound was going to be almost nothing, that it would be almost completely silent, but the microphone managed to pick up quite a bit of the music from the speaker. So something in that chamber is still vibrating enough to get the sound from our speaker to our microphone. There you have it, playing sound and music inside a vacuum chamber. We tried a whole bunch of different varieties with the speaker or the microphone inside the chamber, outside the chamber, both inside the chamber, and I think we got some really good results. And luckily for us, our microphone does still function in a vacuum. That was good to learn. This has been a really fun experiment. I love learning and testing new things like this. Thank you for joining us for this video today, and remember to come gear yourself up with products and merch at thekingofrandom.com. See you there. Hey guys, I'm Nate. Well, man, I'm a little worried about the LCD screen. So far, it seems all right. Sorry, I'm super white.